Hi everybody, it's Natural Me, and I just wanted to come on here with a lock update. 2 weeks ago today, I got my hair interlocked at Deeply Rooted AZ, and I really enjoyed my experience. I was so excited when I was talking with you all that I forgot to add some things. Let me take my glasses off because of the glare. First of all, I just want to say I love, love, love my hair. 2 weeks after a actual retwist, I would look like I have a mini fro with locks on the end. This is 2 weeks after a retwist, after interlocking. And I'm telling you, I am really, really loving my hair. And right now I'm wearing a braid out. I did it, I think, on Monday, Tuesday. So it's 4 or 5 days old. And I'm gonna shampoo my hair and I'm going to try something different. And if it works out, then I will do a tutorial on my next video. So, let you see the back of my hair. Okay, so I am really, really loving my interlocking experience and I am sticking with it. You already know that. One of the things that I learned when I went to the salon is although my roots right now, they look really thin when she interlocked them, they are going to thicken up over time. And interlocking, according to my loctician, is not unhealthy. And it does not thin out your roots. The only way it'll do that is if you interlock too much or like too often. Kind of like when everyone tells you not to retwist your hair or over retwist, you can over interlock and that can thin out your roots. So if you go every 6 weeks or 8 weeks, then there's not an issue. I also learned why sister locks were so expensive because they're both sister lock locticians or sister lock technicians. I really don't know the proper term, but she was talking with me about sister locks because I was just asking her, and the reason why they cost so much is because they have to actually lock your hair from the end all the way to your root. They prefer for a person to have short hair when they interlock it because it's not that you are paying for the individual's time. It can take about, everyone knows it takes about 24 to 48 hours to install sister locks, you know. That's why people do it in like a couple of days increments when they go get them done. And then the maintenance of them is expensive, again, because you are paying for an individual's time. So I learned that too. Also, she was letting me know that when you interlock, you're not supposed to use any product, because the first person I was going to, she was using shea butter. She would kind of retwist a little bit and then interlock. But as I had said before, as soon as I was lifted up from the getting my hair washed and she kind of squeezed the excess water out of my locks, she started her interlocking process. She also said interlocking shouldn't hurt, which I couldn't feel anything that she was doing. I do have some sensitive spots in my head. It's like right here and like my temple area is kind of sensitive, so she really wasn't pulling it really tight, but it still, I could feel what was going on, and it bothered me just a little bit. But once she was done with her rotations of my lock in that area, my sensitive areas, it didn't really hurt anymore. With my experience getting my locks interlocked before, I would complain about my hair itching very bad because it was almost as if the same experience I used to have if I got micro braids or box braids. If they were too tight, my scalp would really itch and it would burn and it'd get really irritated. But with this experience I had 2 weeks ago, my scalp has not itched. Just the normal scalp itching, but not itching as a result of my hair being done too tight. And was there anything else I learned? She just told me a lot of stuff. She educated me a lot on locks overall. I had asked her about a lot of things that I've seen on YouTube. Like, is it healthy to split locks? She was like, no, it's not healthy to split locks. I know some people go through and they split locks using scissors, but you're really kind of damaging your hair because, you know, what if you want to wear it loose and you decide to comb out your locks, then you have damaged hair. I also had asked her, is it healthier to cut your locks off if you want to be a loose natural again, or if it's healthier to comb them out? And she was like, well, if you pick them out, you are still going to damage your hair. You're going to create split ends. That's why a lot of times when a person picks out their locks, you see them in a video shortly after saying that they had to get it trimmed because of the damage. But, you know, whether something is right or wrong is up to the individual. So I'm not saying these things are gospel that I got from my loctician. These were just questions that I had asked her, and she gave me her honest answers. So don't come for me in the comments. I'm just sharing information that I learned. I'm not saying it's right or wrong. But yeah, overall, I am really enjoying my locks being interlocked. I like the fact that I can jump in the shower and douse my hair with water and jump out and not have to worry about puffy roots. And I like that I can shampoo my hair more often, although I haven't been doing that, like shampooing it like several times a week or anything, but I have been spraying it more. I have also been trying to oil my scalp more, and if you give me 1 second, I will show you what I've been using. Okay, I'm back. So I went to the beauty supply store with my daughter last week. We were going so that we can buy her, we're just looking around. And while I was there, I was looking for an oil to start using. I've been using the Jamaican Mango and Lime Island Oil. I just started using it on my scalp. So the goal is to do it 2 times a week, because y'all know before I wasn't oiling my scalp at all. I'm also bought a conditioning spray. I thought this was the conditioning spray that she used on my hair when I got my hair done, but I don't think it is. But I found this on Amazon. It's Enjoy conditioning spray. It also has a pH of 3.5 to 4.5, and it says it's a color holding formula which locks in hair color. I don't know if my camera's gonna focus so you can read that. So I decided to try it. It smells really good. And then I was going to purchase the Talia Wajid Crinkles and Curls, I think it's what it's called, to try for my braid outs. But I've decided instead to use the Argan Oil, the Cream of Nature Argan Oil Style and Shine Foam and Mousse, because it's, the bottle is a little bit bigger and it is a lower price than the Talia Wajid Crinkles and Curls. I can't speak English right now, because as you can see, this is $5.49 and the Talia Wajid product was $8.99, and this is 7 fluid ounces, and I think the Talia Wajid was 6 or 5, I can't remember, but I didn't see the point in paying $8.99 for 5 ounces when I could pay $5.49 for 7 ounces. And I really like the Cream of Nature Argan Oil products, because I do have their spray leave-in as well. It smells very good. So actually what I did to achieve this style, which I'm going to be washing out, is I just wet my hair, I sprayed it down with water, and then I sprayed in this conditioning spray. And then I oiled my scalp and massaged my scalp with the Jamaican Mango and Lime Island Oil. And then I used the Cream of Nature Argan Oil Mousse on my hair. I just put it all over my hair because I just wanted to just do it all at once. And then I put my hair in braids, slept in it overnight, and took it out on Tuesday morning. And my hair has been like this since Tuesday. And then last week, I was wearing a flat twist out, so I couldn't remember when I did my hair, so I had to look at pictures to figure out when I did my hair. But yeah, that is it. So as you can see, my hair is really not that bad for 2 weeks. I'm still sweating a little bit, but it's not as frizzy as it would normally be if I was still doing a palm roll. I really think that interlocking is a good option for me. So that's it. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see y'all in the next video. Bye.